Hi folks, Larry here, Mobile Tech with CannedHamTrailers.com. And today we are beginning the wrap on the 47 main line. Oh, this is an exciting day because I've been waiting for a long time to get here. If I'm talking a little funny, it's because I just got four teeth pulled in the bottom of my mouth, so I've got kind of a hole there. That'll be fixed soon, just waiting for the gums to heal up and the stitches to come out. But at any rate, I'm really excited because I just got the first panel on the 47 main line on the wrap. And I started with this panel because this is where the rear window will be cut. It's an oval shaped window that'll go right here. And it's not so much because of the window that I started here, as much as it is a great place to start because it's a small sheet. I was able to get two of the rafters in, this one and the top one. I've been making those and shellacking panels for the last couple of weeks. As far as the rafters are concerned, I made those myself. You can see right here, here's what they look like. Did all the milling, which I did another video on. That'll be a public video. Most of this trailer, as far as the build is concerned, has been nothing more than updates. At any rate, made 12 of these, only need 10, but I made 12 just in case. And it turns out that was a good idea because I wanted an extra couple, one in the rear down here and one low in the front also. So that was a good idea. But the reason I got this started with this panel is I need a place to start. You might call this the key sheet for this trailer. This sets the pace for all the rest of the trailers, and it was a little hard to do by myself, but I got her done. Now my wonderful helper has just showed up for the bigger panels. Like I say, I've been making these things and shellacking them. Everything's got six coats of shellac. I've also been shellacking the panels, the larger panels that go on here. You can see those over here. One against the wall there, one on the a couple on the tables. And I'll show you the inside now. I'll show you exactly how this panel looks and give you an idea how the rest of the trailer is going to look. There is that panel installed with its two rafters. And the rafters are there for support. They hold the trailer together and they cover up, they give something to attach the seams to all the panels. So they will go all the way around, all the way to the front. And the front has two oval windows in it. We'll be getting to that later. But something to remind you about, I added extra framing in the top corners all the way around the trailer. I did that because this trailer did not have enough attachment points for the wrap. Now this one gets covered up so it didn't have to be shellacked. So this trailer will be held together much better than it used to be and will last quite a bit longer now than it did the first time. There's more of my rafters laying down there waiting to be put to use. These are the things that cover above the windows, cover these pieces that are not shellacked. They'll go on later because I may have to fine tune them to match the wrap. Alrighty. Oops, I can't see myself. I gotta be able to see myself. Now there's something I'd like to share with you before we get started on the wrap here. I've always taught, and you've been hearing me, you know, preach on this for quite a while, about how these trailers are built in a unibody style. That means that everything in the trailer is helping to hold everything else together. A lot of cars are built like that, especially today. They used to have their own frame, and now the frame is part of the body. It's a unibody style, so the entire thing needs to flex. Jet aircraft flex, all airplanes flex, trailers flex. Everything that moves should flex a little bit, and that's why your house is not built to go traveling down the highway over bumps and through potholes at 70 miles an hour. If it was, it would hold together as well as a trailer does. It would even hold together better in earthquakes, wouldn't it? Well, at any rate, when I was stepping in this to do a little shooting, my partner over here told me that I should have seen how this panel flexed when I stepped in and out of the trailer. And this is a good time for me to show you how much your trailer flexes without the wrap on it. Now, this is just the wrap that I'm talking about, not to mention the cabinets and everything. If I didn't have any cabinets in there, it would flex even more. But just without the wrap, and I keep talking about how important the wrap is, that it spans over the walls, over the walls. You can't gut this from the inside and then put extra framing in there or whatever you need to keep the paneling up. To hold new paneling up. You can't do that from the inside because you remove a whole lot of the structural integrity of the trailer by doing so. The wrap has to be installed on the outside of the walls and span over the outside of the walls from one side to the other. That's a whole lot of the structural integrity. Without it, you have a very wobbly trailer. And where do most trailers leak the most? It's in the corner all the way around the wrap. That's where they first start to leak, there and under the windows and any of the other openings. But this is a very important part. That's where this trailer failed, as a matter of fact. It was rotten all the way around the edges, all the way around. And that's why it was falling apart. The cabinets, every place where the cabinets were and everything, it wasn't too rotten. But where the windows are, and especially around the wrap in the corners, the edges all the way around, it was very structurally unsound. I had the whole thing duct taped together to move it up here. All right, I'm going to go ahead and step in and out of the trailer. As a matter of fact, I think I'll just have Steve do it. Steve, would you do that for me?
I'm a lot heavier than you. I don't know if it's a fair comparison.
Oh, go ahead. Go ahead, man. You go ahead and step in there for me. And we're going to see how much this thing tweaks right now. Let me get out of the way. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead and walk around in there. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's, yeah. Move around. It really does show.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, I want to get another view of it also. All right, here's another view. Let's go ahead and see how this looks when you step in and out of the trailer. Go ahead and walk around in the back. Yeah, it doesn't show as good from here, but I can also see it. And actually, that panel's doing quite a bit of work right now. That's one small panel we have in there. But over here, you can really see it, how loose everything is until you get the wrap on it. And actually, it's amazing how much strength just this one little panel is giving it. Anyway, just wanted to demonstrate that to you. It's true. It's not, I don't pull this stuff out of my rear end as some people have accused me of. Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to install this bottom panel. I've got all the wiring ready to go. I have taken care of retufting the buttons on the gaucho, so there's nothing holding me back. We're going to go ahead and install this bottom panel now. Right, I've drilled my holes. I measured down and I measured over for all three sets of wires. And hopefully we got them somewhat close. There's a whole nother layer that goes over this layer to bring it out a quarter inch afterwards. So if I'm off by a little bit, it doesn't really matter. I can adjust it later. And I got to get my gun in my hand here. So let's get that out here where I can get to it. All right, you ready?
Yep.
All right, we'll go ahead and run our wires through. Don't want to forget that important process. There we go. This is not an easy job to perform. None of them are, I guess. For one thing, it wants to warp the wrong way in the middle. Does it need to come to me a 32nd of an inch?
Just a tip.
Okay, that wrecked it all.
Okay, I'm good here.
Okay. See, it's bent the wrong way here, so it won't line. Ooh, don't move it too far. This end will fall.
Okay.
I've got to get it to pop the other way. There. Why it doesn't want to come together in the middle, I don't know. We'll find out here in a minute. Doesn't line up in the middle for some reason. I don't know why. Can't be that round. I'm thinking if you go inside and push out on this framework,
okay.
I'm thinking that might have something to do with it. It might actually be pushed in a little bit. Push out slightly on the bottom framework. Oh, we didn't. Yeah, do it more. A little more. There. I know what the problem is. That's not going to stay. Go ahead and come on out. I know what the problem is. We didn't put the jacks back under it after,
Oh, shit.
Yeah. That's one of the problems we're having.
Okay.
Moving around all over the place. Oh, yeah. Every time I film, I forget to do things.
Yeah. I said, you're right. Put the stands under it, and it fell right into place.
Yeah, I just basically forgot. And I can, yeah, we can tweak and adjust. But, yeah. Yeah, I noticed that as soon as you walked in there. Now, if you go back in there again and push out on it, I can put all the tacks in the top. And keep it pushed out.
How's that?
A little more. Okay, a little too much. Right there. Doggone it. Hold on. It's shooting right through the paneling.
Go ahead and adjust it.
Might push it out a bit. Come on. I don't know why it's not taking. Still too much. All right, over to your left, push out a bit. Why is that not shooting into the wood? All right, let go. Ah, everything fell apart. It all popped. Come on out.
Okay.
It all fell apart. This all fell apart. I gotta get all those out now. Oh, darn it. Stuff like that. Well, nothing goes right when the damn camera's on, you know that. Well, there it is. I had to turn the camera off because things were not going properly. Nothing was working out. I missed on the wires in the middle. And I don't know how I did that. It was an inch and a half mistake. So I got a little hole I'll have to plug there, and I'll do that later on. These came out perfect. But at any rate, it's on there. It's stapled all the way around with 3/4 inch staples. I had to start on the top with screws because the staples, because this paneling is so thin, because the paneling is about half the thickness they used to make it now, and it's just a cardboard filler. The middle ply is cardboard. I hate this stuff, but it's getting harder and harder to find good paneling. So I put screws along the top to hold it because this radius kept wanting to pull the thing out through the staples. We got it on there now. It'll start molding to its own shape, you know, and keep this shape. And later on, we'll just cover these screws up because they're flat screws. There's another layer that goes over all this, and that'll help quite a bit. So, at any rate, there is the bottom part of the wrap for the rear. Now we're going to move to the front and get that on. Okay, this is a drawing that I made way back when I disassembled this thing. Remember, disassembly and discovery? Hard to say when you have no teeth in the front of your face. So I know where this first rafter goes. It centers on the same place where these two pieces of plywood come together. Did that in the rear, and then there's another one 18 inches up, as you can see. And then I'll do that in the front. There's another one 17 1/4 inches up. Why? I don't know. Don't ask me. It's just the way they built it. So I rebuild them. If you're like I always say, if you rebuild them exactly the way they built it in the factory, you should have no problems. You can always add more if you want, which I'm doing. I'm adding one there and one here in the middle of the radius at the bottom there, just for strength. So there'll be two extra rafters. These are all rafter points right here, and also where the plywood breaks up all the way around the wrap. So I know that 39 1/2 inches up from the bottom of where this paneling will stop is where the center point of my rafter will be, going across that way, across the front of the trailer. I also know that it centers on this break in the plywood. So that's how I know where to start. Then all I have to do is measure each place in between all the way up for where the rafters go, and my panels will be cut accordingly and set right on there. The only other full 48 that we have is this piece right here. You can call that the key sheet over the door there. Either one of these you can call the key sheet. But you only use the key sheet first and start there first when you're dealing with a frame, a piecemeal project. When you're dealing with a frame off, you have to get the floor level and get it jacked up so it doesn't move. You have to get your radius in the front and the rear started first, and I'm going off the windows where they start, and then I go down and then I go up from there. Here we've got the back done already, so we'll go up from there. We'll meet in the middle. Any deviation that we have to deal with that's a little bit off, we will deal with on our last sheet that goes in the middle, on what we normally call the key sheet. Other than that, we will build on both of these ends going towards the middle. All right, this right here is where the plywood separates from the top sheet to the bottom sheet. That's where we want to center this this rafter. So I'll make a line straight across like that, and I'll put a line on the rafter showing its center, and I'll do this on both sides. Go over here, do the same thing. See, in this case, this little 18 inch panel is my key sheet. So I have a key sheet on both ends. That's because it's a frame off. You got to get someplace right to base the rest of your paneling off of so that it's square, because you have nothing to start with that's right. And you say, well, why can't you start at the bottom? Well, I can do that, but I definitely want the windows to be level, and the windows are held in by this and its other matching top piece of framework. So I don't want the paneling deciding what level is. I want level to be deciding what level is. And what I mean by level is horizontal plumbness with the floor, the box seats, and the rest of the trailer. So I'll go ahead and mark the center of this rafter, and we will get her up there. All right, we're just screwing in this rafter. And of course, because of the grain, the drill wants to find the easiest way into the rafter, so the rafter can move around from the grain when you're trying to drill. So you want to start by just lightly, light pressure on the drill bit before you push it all the way in, because it'll move the rafter around. I've already done that. We're putting the screw in now. All right, in the front, we're doing things a little bit different because I figured one thing wrong as far as where this brace goes, this rafter. I had it in the wrong place. I just assumed it'd be the same as on the front. Well, I went outside here where I stored all the paneling that came off of the rack so I could double check things. Remember how I'm always telling you people, don't throw anything away till you're done. And it's a good thing for me that I didn't, because this thing doesn't go here, it goes down here. And I went out twice now and double checked my measurements. So rather than put the window part in first, we've decided to go ahead and get the panel started on this end, because we are limited to where we can go because of the tongue, which stops it. So I have to get it square with the walls, which we've been doing using this for adjustment, and got the whole bottom screwed in now on the bottom rafter, or the bottom floor joist, which is where all, where the wrap starts. So it's nice and flat on the bottom. And now we'll start coming up both sides, and we'll adjust the wall to meet with the paneling as we go. And that's the way we're gonna do that. It's my story and I'm sticking with it. All right, now, you just hold it flat along the top is all you need to do. We'll take care of the rest, all right? Not quite enough air. That's perfect. Maybe too much now, when you know it. In and then go to the other side. You don't do one whole side first and then go to the other. You start your radius, get it up a little bit, and then go to the other side and get that one up a little bit. I'm doing that right now. Oh yeah, this is coming out great. Now, we need another strap here on this end. Just pull things together. Let me get another strap. Okay, that strap brought it in enough. Perfect. These just don't want to go in all the way. Could be a knot. That happens.
It's better if they go in not enough rather than too much, because if too much, it goes right through. Not enough, you just pound them in like that. Now what we got to do is move this guy down to halfway over this seam. Fix our mistake. Glad I checked. All right, sometimes when I get things going right, I just forget to turn the camera on because everything's going right. But we had to make a few adjustments, use the strap to squeeze this in, and then I stapled it the rest of the way up. And the same on the other side. And now we have that sheet in there. So from here, this determines where our front windows are, because they're in this next sheet. Let me get the camera where you can see. Okay. Jeez, my big feet. You know, how did I ever get anything photographed when I worked in the other place back in Paris? Just amazing. The only thing I'm really sorry about is I have two holes here now that show. I'll have to putty those and seal them up with something. No biggie. But at any rate, now what happens is our next sheet goes on top of this one along with our brace up here. Or a brace for ceiling framing or rafter, whatever you want to call it. It goes up there. So that's where we're going to go next. And from there, then I got to do a lot more shellacking and all the rest of the panels go on. But this will complete the front and the rear. I've got to try and get this piece in by myself because my helper left for the time being. And then we'll be back. I don't want to wait. So, here we go. Looking good. Now I'm only putting six staples in here too. Well, actually five, because the top cross member isn't in there yet. And that's mainly because I'm not sure if I'm going to cut these windows out, which there's two that go here. I don't know if I'm going to cut them out on the trailer or if I'm going to take these pieces back down and cut them out. I don't know yet. I haven't figured out how I'm going to cut those holes yet. So I'm only putting in enough staples to hold it there. Because I may have to, like I say, I may have to come back and pull it out. But we're getting all four pieces up, front and rear wrap up to just above the windows. And then I will go back into the shellacking mode and shellack the rest of the wrap so that it can all go on in one day, hopefully. So we got the front and the rear on in one day. We'll just see how it goes. I'm trying to get as much of this recorded as I can. Because my helper had to leave, I'm using my cheap helper here, which is my straps. There. The straps are here when you need them. So that's what I'm doing. Get a thing where you want it, and then tighten the strap. Everything should work out great. There, one tighten is all I needed. One little tighten there. I hope everything stays still while you shoot it. Just put one staple in the middle, one on the ends to hold everything. And then I can put screws in the sides. Okay.
And I'll go ahead and put the screws in the side for that framing piece there. And then after that, I will be able to remove this if need be, because it's only got 6 staples in it. I can remove that to cut the windows if I need to remove it to cut the windows. I don't know for sure they'll have to do that. So it just depends. We'll see. Meantime, I'll go ahead and screw in the sides of that framing piece. Yep, you can always find a way to do it yourself. It usually just takes longer and it's a little more difficult, but you can find a way. Is that going? I think it is. Yep. To hit a screw under there or something. I don't know what I could have hit. Really shouldn't be anything there. Yeah, I don't know what I was hitting. There's nothing there. A knot, probably. All right, one side to go. The other side, do the same thing.